Welcome to our special design episode where we feature design icons and icons of desire. In this episode, we'll join international designer Kenneth Kobonpwe in his hometown Cebu and take a look at his latest creations and his growing collection of classic Ferraris. We'll see the designer's love for fast cars and good design through the lens of an icon to understand the passion behind the legendary Leica brand. Then we'll unbox one of the world's most recognizable and enduring timepieces, the Omega Speedmaster, a watch collector's dream that's celebrating 50 years as the first on the moon. So join us, I'm David Celdran, and this is Executive Class. Our episode on good design begins in Cebu, a city in the Philippines known around the world for its furniture design and manufacturing industry. Cebu is a hometown as well of the country's most celebrated designer, Kenneth Kobonpwe. Kenneth has achieved international acclaim and commercial success for his unique woven designs, which combine natural elements, local motifs, and Cebuano hand craftsmanship. His showroom in downtown Cebu traces his journey as a designer, as well as the pieces that have become icons of his global brand. We caught up with Kenneth in Cebu during filming for a new campaign of Ferrari. Kenneth is the only Filipino and among the few Asians picked by the Italian sports car manufacturer to represent the brand in their latest international campaign. Kenneth, after all, isn't just a well-known sports car aficionado with rare vintage Ferraris in his collection. He's also one of Asia's most prominent names in the creative industry. The perfect person to represent a car brand driven by the same passion.
You're good. Okay, he's good. So we're just about ready to begin our first location shoot with Kenneth Kobonpwe, who's over there at the driver's wheel. Now, the Portofino is the perfect car for the kind of terrain that we're going to drive through.
For 2 days in Cebu, we shadowed Kenneth and the Ferrari crew from Singapore around the hills and streets of his native city, doing what he loves best, driving, top-down when possible, but always fast. So fast, we could hardly keep up with him. The Portofino Gran Turismo lent to Kenneth is the ideal vehicle for Cebu's scenic coastal roads, mountainous terrain, and year-round beach weather. It's not quite the vintage sports car he likes to collect, but the powerful convertible provides an exhilarating ride nevertheless. So much so that I just had to join him for a ride after filming was over. The front seat of a sports car is the best place to chat and catch up with Kenneth. It's when the designer is happiest. The last time we did the same was many years ago, and in a different, much older Ferrari, his prized possession, a rare vintage Dino. The Dino Kenneth paid a premium to acquire still takes center stage in his garage, where it has pride of place. It's the only Ferrari built without the Prancing Pony logo, a tiny detail not lost on serious collectors. But the Dino's true fame is derived from its compelling backstory, a one-off car model named after the son of founder Enzo Ferrari, Dino, who passed away tragically. Though the classic design and high performance of the car adds to the Dino's value. It's the same with the other classic cars in Kenneth's collection.
I, in particular, like classic cars because I like them for their simplicity, their purity. There's nothing electronic, and it's an age where there were no, basically, safety standards to be met then. And so the objects were designed by the designer. They were very pure, they were uncluttered, and, you know, when you look at them, they're all, it's metal, steel, glass, and the materials are very, very pure.
the Testarossa, what a beauty.
Last time we featured Kenneth and his cars, he only had one Ferrari back then, which was a Dino, which is of course Kenneth's favorite Ferrari. But since then he's added two more, this one over here. Kenneth built a new garage in his sprawling Cebu property to house his latest acquisitions. Although from a different generation of Ferraris, the Testarossa, his new favorite, and the Maranello, named after the hometown of Ferrari. Though the two look different on the surface, both are fitted with Ferrari's legendary V12 naturally aspirated engines, both painted in bright Ferrari red, and both equally iconic.
So when you look at Ferraris, there's not really one thread that goes through them. They're each product of the era from which they came from. Also because they experimented a lot with where to place the engine. So they were front, they were mid, they had rear, you know, and then they started to, they had the two-seaters, four-seaters, and then, yeah, they were each really a product of their, of that generation, from the wedge shape to really curvy shapes. And in fact, what's fascinating is that the early designs were all hand-built. You know? So when you hand-build something, you could experiment. You could build, go in very, very small numbers, small runs, and so you could afford to be experimental. I mean, just like what we do in the factory today.
It's the same passion for experimentation and a dedication to hand craftsmanship seen in Kenneth Cobenque furniture.
Oh, I've come a long way since I started. I began to experiment with open weave structures, because that was what I was trying to do, to create these volumes of transparent structures, you know, miniature structures. And from then on, I began to develop more closed, and then I discovered fabric, what I could do with fabric. With that, then I began another journey using color, and then I created the bloom chair, which was totally upholstered chair. So I've done a lot of things in my design journey. There is not one look with which a Kenneth Cobenque furniture or piece is associated with.
But if you were to find a common thread through those decades, through those years, what would it be? What would still be trademark Kenneth Cobenque?
It'd probably be the handmade, still the handmade weave.
His unique designs and the quality of his pieces have propelled Kenneth Cobenque to global prominence. But it isn't just the critics, architects, and collectors who recognize his achievements, but global brands like Ferrari, and recently, the Disney Company.
Yes, so Disney approached me and says, can we do something with it from the world of Star Wars? And the first thing I told him was, you know, I don't put characters on my pieces, and I would never make replicas, so you don't need to come to me if you wanted replicas of existing machines.
Exactly.
And so they said, no, we want you to interpret the world of Star Wars through a Filipino designer's lens.
Wow.
And so I said, wow, now that's okay. That's a challenge.
The playful pieces inspired by the familiar characters, weapons, and flying machines of the series may seem out of place alongside Kenneth's more original and organic designs, but they embody the same experimental fervor and signify the natural evolution of his creative process as a designer.
That's part of my design vocabulary, this reinterpretation of the natural world, you know, and making it applicable to anything we use. And so, in the case of Star Wars, that was really a challenge to try to take something that everybody knew, you know, these TIE fighters or all these things that we grew up with. And it was a challenge to not only to make it, but to get them to be accepted by millions of fans around the world.
So far, Star Wars fans and Kenneth's own avid followers have responded enthusiastically. A reminder indeed that though tried and tested formulas may work in designing furniture or manufacturing sports cars, it's only by constantly reinterpreting, experimenting, and improving that one can create a design considered iconic. Up next, timeless designs that employ cutting-edge technology Executive Class returns with the legendary cameras of Leica and the iconic Speedmaster Moonwatch of Omega.